and she's always with us.
I mean, if it starts to
drink,
I think she'll be okay.
I'll text you.
I'll just put her in here and take her
So, I was talking to Ms. Becker, right? And she was already talking about, does anyone want to know if there is summer reading assignment in? And I was like, it's not a summer reading
assignment. Me too.
I emailed Ms. Pender this morning. I'm like, yeah, so I'm not going to be in class.
Uh-huh.
And she's like, oh yeah, we're just going over summer reading. I'll post it.
I'm a reading.
It's not even the last day of school yet, and you're already talking about summer reading.
Exactly.
Why?
I don't know, because Ms. Fletcher, she was like, does anyone know what their summer reading assignment is for next year? I was like,
he's a lot.
But I did it anyway, because why not get a head start?
Oh no. If I get a head start, it's not being finished until August. I didn't finish my essay until like August 29th.
I didn't finish my essay until the day it was due.
I'll wait till tomorrow.
I don't know.
You're better.
September, who knows what.
I don't know.
So guys, listen up. In the back. So, pomp and circumstances first, right? Don't forget. And then just stay ready because the national anthem will be right after that. Okay? And then obviously we'll sit through the ceremony and then play at the very end. Again, I don't care if you go on your phones, just be discreet. Don't be making phone calls. Don't be taking selfies.
Oh, we're Victoria. Gonna
posting on Instagram and
we're gonna take 20 selfies. I'm going to gambling and jump up.
Yeah, yeah.
Take a video on Snapchat.
It's gonna be graduates. I'll take 2021 pictures.
Shall we tune? We need to warm up.
And then at the end,
guys, let's tune real quick, alright?
I know, still all things.
Sharp. You're sharp. You're good. Sharp. Sharp. Go again, Shabon. Sharp. Very, very sharp. Sharp.
Five to six. Will the audience please rise for the student processional? You may be seated. It is an honor and distinct privilege to welcome you to Bordentown Regional High School's 2021 commencement. Today, we gather as a school community to commemorate and celebrate the remarkable class of 2021. On behalf of our beloved faculty and staff, I would like to extend the heartiest of congratulations to our graduating seniors for all of the hard work and effort that brought them here today. We hope that despite the challenges of 2020, you have found yourselves today to be stronger, more adaptive, and better prepared than ever before to face the demands that life inevitably brings. Congratulations on reaching this important milestone. We are extremely proud of each and every one of you. And now, I present to you Senior Nicholas Eifert, who will lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance. Please rise.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please remain standing for the national anthem as sung by Kayla Downing, class of 2021.
Say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets in glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled
please be seated.
Looks awesome out there, I just want to let you know. And you look pretty amazing back there. Welcome to the BRHS commencement exercises for the class of 2021. My name, as you know from all the emails, is Rob Walder, and it's my pleasure to share this evening with our 2021 graduates, their families and friends. This graduation tonight is more than a wonderful celebration. It is a miraculous accomplishment. This is the conclusion of your academic efforts, and it's also a time of great pride and happiness, not only for you, but your parents, your relatives, but also for our faculty and administration. It's a time when we can say, we did it. You did it. And you know it felt like it took forever to get here. At this time, it's my pleasure to welcome our guests. This first introduction is a special one that is a little bittersweet. Dr. Forstoffer, please stand. So, this will be the last commencement exercise for Dr. Forstoffer as he is retiring this year after many distinguished years of educational service. I, for one, feel quite fortunate that we had him, his experience leading our district for the past 7 years. How about a nice, loud round of applause for Edward J. Forstoffer III. Class of 2021, you are so special that you have two superintendents at your ceremony. It's my pleasure to introduce to you our future superintendent here in Bordentown, Dr. Trudy Atkins. Also with us tonight is our business administrator, Mrs. Shafonda Henry. Our assistant principal for athletics, Ms. Jennifer Ciccali, is around here somewhere. You know our other assistant principal, Miss Meredith Morley. And certainly Mrs. Teresa Huff. Also with us here, we're proud to have our Board of Education President, Ms. Eileen Francisco Cabas. And three of our board members, Mr. Joseph Dean, Ms. Janet Nielsen. Actually, we had another, but she couldn't make it. Also, you'll be hearing from our four counselors up here in the future, and our junior class, soon to be senior class president. At this point, let's get started. Ms. Morley.
Thank you and welcome. It is my pleasure to begin the program by introducing the class salutatorian. This is an exceptional young woman who has maintained a GPA of 110.11. Please join me in welcoming the salutatorian of the class of 2021, Ms. Shreya Manick.
Good evening to the school board members, administrators, teachers, families, friends, and graduating seniors. Coming to terms with the complexities of life can be difficult for all, especially a group of graduating adolescents. Yet, we can turn to the Care Bears for a bit of philosophical help. Sharing is caring seems to be an ideal philosophy. However, an academic must always support their claims with valid evidence. Therefore, I would like to take you all on a journey to find evidence for this controversial claim presented by the Care Bears. The most convenient place to find proof of sharing equating caring would be our own homes. There were many days where we lost our sanity over a 5-page essay on a Shakespearean play or inhaled somewhat dangerous paint fumes when decorating the homecoming hallway. And during these days, our loved ones shared so much love with us. They would act as a blanket of comfort during tough times. And honestly, times were pretty tough. And even when times weren't that tough, that blanket was still there. Take my family as an example. My father likes to share the most interesting foods with us. About 4 months ago, he bought almonds that literally taste like pizza. For a long time, I shunned these nonsensical almonds, but a couple weeks ago, my mother told me that he bought these almonds to improve our memories and taste buds. He bought flavored almonds so he could make me a better student. Sounds a bit ridiculous, but it's just part of the reason why I'm so grateful for my parents. Often, families and other loved ones are the epitome of sharing is caring. Although I have already found plentiful evidence of sharing is caring in our homes, I have another source, the Bordentown Regional High School. This past year, Bordentown teachers have not only shared academic knowledge, but have also provided immense benevolence and patience. It is not just the teachers in our school. I have seen fellow students, guidance counselors, and administrators do the same. For example, during Black History Month and Pride Month, the school hosted a series of webinars regarding social identity in America. I saw my peers, counselors, teachers, and administrators take out time from their day to empower the school community. Also, we were even nurtured by hidden figures, just like the underrated writers for the Care Bears movies. particularly the custodial and cafeteria staff, allowed us to thrive in a healthy environment. It is crucial to remember that the Care Bears successfully care because they are a team, and the high school's team of staff has created a culture where sharing is caring is an undeniable claim. In proving my thesis, I must not forget the integral element of friendships. The Care Bears themselves were a tight-knit group of friends, so I should analyze our friendships as well. Of course, it would be difficult for over 150 kids to all be friends, but our shared experience of being physically distant teenagers brought us closer to the friends we already had. Just about 2 weeks ago, my friends and I had a small picnic. I'm not going to lie, initially I thought that my lack of social skills would inhibit us from having a good time. But then I heard them sharing stories on how they're going to defend themselves with car keys in college. Yes, I agree, it is an odd conversation, but I love listening to their laughs in real time. It made me remember why I don't have to worry about being awkward around them. My relationships are now extremely similar to the bonds that the Care Bears had. We must all try our best to keep our bear packs intact for the sake of these bonds. With all this evidence, it would be beneficial if we bring some nuance to the Care Bears' claim. Sharing is not just caring. Sharing brings love, empowerment, kindness, and comfort. So the Care Bears were right. They just needed to continue their sentence a bit, and we would have a full-on thesis statement. Of course, I did not intend to talk about thesis statements, but having Ms. Ingram as an English teacher for 2 years really pushed me to do so. I was given a tremendous amount of evidence for the sharing is caring claim. What else was I supposed to do? What I do know is that sometimes going back to our favorite childhood characters can provide us with some deep philosophical guidance. Thank you.
Thank you, Shreya. I would now like to introduce Rishi Makampali, our next select member of the senior class, who will introduce the senior choir collection.
BRHS Senior Choir, under the direction of Miss Ellen Kirk, will now perform its selection. Will the senior members of the choir please join Miss Kirk?
Doo 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 doo. tears are in your eyes. I'll dry them all. I'll dry them all. Do, 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 do. I'm on your side. Oh, when times are rough.
That song was called Bridge Over Troubled Waters by composer Paul Simon, arranged by Audrey Sinder. Thank you, Ms. Kirk, and our choir for that wonderful selection.
Thank you, Rishi. At this point in the ceremony, it is my distinct honor to present a remarkable young man. He has maintained a four-year grade point average of 110.66. Ladies and gentlemen, the valedictorian of the class of 2021, Mr. Matthew Logadice.
Those of you that know me know I'm not someone who would jump at the opportunity to make a speech in front of hundreds of people. Originally, I planned to be a high-ranking student, but not high enough to prepare this very speech. So much for that. In all seriousness, it is truly an honor to speak to you all at this momentous occasion. Time really flies. During my frantic first year at this school, an upperclassman told me something that I still remember. You can't really get lost in this school. It's just a big square. She was right. It is a square, but these last 4 years, it's become so much more than that. It's pep rallies, team spirit, and a tight-knit community. And it's you, the teachers, coaches, administrators, parents, and lastly, the students, who made this school and this year so great. Thank you for everything you've done to get us to this point, and thank you for my family for pushing me all these years. Thanks, Mom, for always nagging me about deadlines that sometimes were months away. Thank you, Dad, for showing me the importance of passion and hard work. And thank you to my big sister, Marissa, for being a role model who's working hard in college. She made me say that. I could spend this time reminiscing, but I think it'd be more productive to focus on what's next in the coming years. We will be attending colleges across the country, from California to Miami, and majoring in areas of finance to chemical engineering. Not to mention those who may go into trades or the military. Whatever our color or sex, whatever our financial or cultural background, we can make sure that we find success with whatever we may do. Soon we'll begin to realize that high school is simply a stepping stone along the way into the real world. Go forward and secure a safe and prosperous future. Aristotle once said, "Excellence is no accident. It is always the result of high intention, sincere effort, and intelligent execution." It's all up to you. Time flies, but the good news is you're the pilot. Congratulations, class of 2021.
It is now my pleasure to introduce our superintendent, Dr. Edward J. Forstoffer III.
Good evening, members of the Board of Education, Mr. Walder, parents, faculty, honored guests, and most importantly, the graduating class of 2021. When a college professor retires, he or she is afforded the opportunity to teach a last lecture. Although I'm not a professor, I hope you'll indulge me as I give my own brief list of life lessons along with some real-world examples as my last lecture. Now, I've grouped my lessons around four general principles that I believe will offer you the best chance of success in living your life after high school graduation. These rules are seek change and new ideas, be nice and courteous, appreciate what you have, and dream. Now, I can practically hear your eyes rolling. I will keep the cliches down in my speech, but I will hope you will hear some real-life anecdotes that may ring true for you. So our first topic is seek change and new ideas. You've heard this before, but how many of you have actively attempted it? I thought of this because of running. I never understood runners. Driving places in my car and seeing people running or jogging on the shoulder of the road, I would remember thinking, if God wanted us to run, cars never would have been invented. Then I turned 50. Now our education foundation does a yearly run in the city, and as superintendent, I would MC the event. After the first year, I decided to see if I could run the 3.1 miles that make a 5K. I did it, I finished it, and now I'm a runner. I know, you look at me and you think, he doesn't look like a runner. Well, since that first 5K, I've run countless 5Ks, 9 half marathons, and 1 full marathon of 26.2 miles. So if you don't think I look like a runner, just imagine what I would look like if I didn't run. So running for me was a new idea. I was looking for some change in my life and discovered running. If you're open to receiving new ideas, you'll experience so much more in life. Don't be afraid to challenge yourself, and you may surprise yourself with what you can do. The next principle is to be nice and courteous. The best way to accomplish this is to hang out with nice and courteous people. Now, unfortunately, I have to tell you that in a room full of people, there's always a negative, mean, or rude person in any group that you'll come across. Your job is to find that person and not allow yourself to start thinking like he or she does. Trust me, they will try to bring you down. Now, if you go into a room full of people and you can't find the rude or mean person, like Emily Wheeler said last night, it's probably you. If that's the case, go back to the first principle and seek change and new ideas. Believe it or not, it's really easy to be nice. If you only take one thing from this speech, let it be to be nice and courteous. You can start tonight. When you go home later and you have a snack, put your own dishes in the dishwasher or wash and dry them yourself. You will not believe the reaction you will get. You want an even better reaction? Wash the dishes that one of your parents left in the sink. Pick up your clothes, vacuum a room. You'll be amazed at the reaction. Just be nice. My third theme is to appreciate what you have. Now, appreciating what you have sounds easy, but we rarely do it. I'm going to let you in on a little secret. Whoever said that you get better with age was a liar. You got to be kidding me. Play your parents in a game that you're good at, say one-on-one basketball. Whether your parent wins or loses, he or she will need 3 days of bed rest to recover. I get sore from playing soccer on my son's Xbox. Do you realize that when you get to be my age, you get sore from sleeping? I mean, we don't jump out of bed anymore. We push ourselves up into a seated position and think about standing. And sometimes that thinking will go on for quite a while. Enjoy your youth because it's fleeting. A lifetime is not very long. Right now, according to actuarial sciences, you've lived 1/5 of your life. Sounds pretty good, except that if you go to a 4-year college, when you graduate, you would have already lived 1/4 of your life. Wait until you see how fast those years fly by. It was not too long ago that your parents were wearing their high school graduation gowns and listening to a much less engaging graduation speaker. Appreciate what you have and what others have done for you. If you get a chance, write a short note of thanks to that teacher who helped or inspired you. I've received a few notes through my years, and I promise you, they do not end up in the garbage can. Tonight's also a great time to tell your parents how much you appreciate all that they've done for you. You do not know how great just hearing those words will make them feel. It actually makes the soreness from getting out of bed all worth it. My final principle is to dream. As much as I want you to appreciate what you have, you have to envision what you don't have and make it happen. Your world will be a very different place starting tomorrow. You are no longer the center of the universe. Things will not be given to you in life, so go out there and earn them. Stephen Covey says, begin with an end in mind. So my advice to you is to dream of where you want to be, but do not rely on luck to get there. Have a plan. Without a good plan, your dream will likely never come to be. Here's an example of poor dream planning. I've done this. You go out and you buy a new pair of pants that are too tight because you want those pants to be an inspiration to lose weight. And 6 months later, you still haven't worn the pants and now they're out of style. Dreams do not just happen because you want them to. Do not be afraid to roll up your sleeves, get your hands dirty, and make them happen. So there are my words of wisdom. Seek change and new ideas, be nice, appreciate what you have, and dream. You started kindergarten 4,700 days ago. And in that time, you've acquired quite a bit of knowledge. But if you can remember these four principles in that I before E thing, you will be very successful. Now, several years ago, I came across a poem that I feel is entirely appropriate for this event. So I've used it at the conclusion of every one of the graduations that I've spoken to. It seems most appropriate tonight because of my four rules. So I'd like to conclude my words by encouraging you to follow the advice of an unknown author in the poem, Dream Big. If there were ever a time to dare, to make a difference, to embark on something worth doing, it is now. Not for any grand cause necessarily, but for something that tugs at your heart, something that is worth your aspiration, something that is your dream. You owe it to yourself to make your days count. Have fun, dig deep, stretch, dream big. Know, though, that things worth doing seldom come easy. There will be times when you want to turn around, pack it up, and call it quits. Those times tell you that you are pushing yourself and that you are not afraid to learn by trying. Persist. Because with an idea, determination, and the right tools, you can do great things. Let your instincts, your intellect, and let your heart guide you. Trust. Believe in the incredible power of the human mind, of doing something that makes a difference, of working hard, of laughing and hoping, of lasting friends, of all the things that will cross your path. Next year, the start of something new brings the hope of something great. Anything is possible. There is only one you, and you will pass this way but once. Do it right. Dream big. So please accept my best wishes for continued achievement, happiness, and health in your future. I hope that each of you accomplishes whatever dream you have set for yourself by seeking new ideas while being nice and appreciative of the people who have brought you to where you are today. And the next time you go for a run or try something you haven't done, like washing the dishes, think back fondly of your days at Bordentown Regional High School. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Forsthoffer. Now I'm honored to introduce our president of the Board of Education, Ms. Eileen Francisco Cavis.
Thank you so much. Good evening. Well, I get to be the less engaging speaker of your memory. So first, welcome parents, thank you, and welcome distinguished guests, fellow board members, administrators, staff, teachers, parents, families, supporters, and last but not least, the class of 2021. I would like you to indulge me for just a minute, because for now, you're still our students, so I get to kind of tell you what to do. Please put your feet flat on the ground, relax in your seats, and get comfortable. Don't worry, it's not gonna be long, it's just a practice. I want you to feel for the roots that are on the ground. Feel the roots that are reaching up through the benches, through this ground, to the people who are out here and into that building. I want you to think with those roots, you are sending down everything that you must put behind right now because of the next steps of your life. I want you to send it down, send whatever it is that you must be ready to leave behind for whatever next step is coming. And on top of that, I want you to now send down everything you want to leave behind for every single student that's going to walk through these halls after you, because you are rooted to them. Every change, everything that you've tried to make better here, every way that you've added to Bordentown, you are the root. And I want you to send it down so that every future generation walks through and feels and learns from you and carries with them the knowledge of how you handled the tough times, how you handled the victories and the losses. Leave that for them. And then on top of that, send down through this root into this earth who you are right now, because that's going to carry with you everywhere. You don't send it down and forget it. You're sending it down here because this is the continued impact you make on Bordentown, on your family, on the world. And yes, all of these things are going to get muddled with so many of the life choices you're going to make and other decisions you're going to have to make and I challenge you that when you feel lost, you come back and you put your feet in this place and you feel what it was, the optimism and potential of everything you are right now. And you remember. And you remember the day that you are already fulfilled. Great challenge, and you already addressed it. And now, whenever you come back, either it be physically here or in this mental space, come back to that person who has everything possible in front of them and carry that with you. For everyone in the stands, everyone in the auditorium, thank you for all of your support of these students. I know the phrase, I can't believe they're graduating. Didn't we just drop them off at kindergarten? Has come through many of your lips, no doubt. And for you younger siblings, older siblings, who has watched the growth, and am I gonna face all of that too? The potential is all there. The success is all yours. Unfortunately, as a fellow parent, I know the fear of, will they make friends? And, oh, is that going to be a good influence of a friend? It will come up. It doesn't end our worry for you, our love for you, our care. It will be eternal, just as your roots are here. It is an African proverb that said, when the roots run deep, there is no fear of wind. And the winds change. So carry that with you. It is our privilege to send you off. And we, as those who have helped set your roots, we're gonna watch where your branches fly, where you reach. And since we are outdoors, I can tell you to look up. And there isn't a ceiling. Congratulations, class of 2021.
Thank you, Dr. Forsthoffer and Mrs. Francisco Cavis. Remember, class of 2021, what I told you about the rousing round of applause after I finished? I said it's got to be bigger than Forsthoffer. It's got to be bigger than the president. Just don't forget that. It's my pleasure to share a few words in honor of the class of 2021. What a beautiful night we have here. Surely it is a sign of what's to come for this class. Nothing but great things. This is the best day and evening of the school year. Always. But especially this year. You know what we've been through. I don't have to tell you. You, we all lived it. However, tonight, it's time to put all that past us. Tonight, we rejoice in our success. In your success. Through all this mayhem and uncertainty, you did it. My brief comments to you tonight will not focus on all that we have missed. They will focus on what you accomplished, what you have now, and what lies in front of you. This year, you competed on the athletic fields, participated in the band and strings ensemble, performed two theater productions, and participated in extracurricular activities. For that matter, you created at least new 4 clubs this year. By the way, thank you, Board of Education members, for approving those new clubs. The point is, despite these unique conditions, you all prospered, you carried on, and you all flourished. Technology. Just think of all you learned in utilizing new devices, programs, software, etc. We were practically paperless this school year. Your tech skills are through the roof. You met the challenge and you adapted. Zoom, Google, Flipgrid, Jamboards, Pear Deck, breakout rooms. I bet you're kind of glad that you don't have to hear those terms for at least a few more weeks. Let's talk about what you have now, what you've just received. You have a really cool new face covering, the class of 2021. You have a brand new cap and gown. And of course you have some class of 2021 t-shirts. That's all cool and new. You have that? No, I'm just kidding. But seriously, you now have a top flight educational foundation that has provided you an excellent opportunity to be successful in whatever it is that you plan to do next. Speaking of next, let's take a little survey. Please stand if you are planning to attend a 2 or 4 year college. Thank you, you may be seated. How about those of you who are going straight into the working world or attending a trade school, please stand. Thank you. Finally, those of you out there who are considering or have decided on joining the military. Thank you. Thank you for choosing to serve our country. Back to what you have. Creative thinking skills, writing skills, speaking skills, content knowledge, like the fact that a mole is also a scientific term. That's true. I heard that. The fact that Grant is the person actually buried in Grant's tomb, and how many ounces in a kilometer? You get what I'm saying. You get what I mean. You're prepared and you're ready. In fact, in the past 2 days, I ran into 2 former students who just finished their undergrad and are off to graduate school, one for occupational therapy and the other for sports administration. That may be you in 4 years. Do you know what else you have right now? You have a caring and supportive family. Those people out here who have stood by your side, who woke you up in time to log into block 1, and then woke you up again 15 minutes later in block 1 because you fell asleep. That's your family. Your family that met these COVID challenges head on, just like you have done. In one way or another, it's probably many ways, they were there for you, offering encouragement for your academic work, guidance for the college search, and suggestions for your future in the military or the working world. Understand, they will be there for you always, next week, next month, and even next year. So like Dr. Forstoffer mentioned, appreciate them. You might not be sure what is up ahead in your future. That's okay. You will figure it out. A couple of you might explore a gap year and work to make some money. That's okay too. Some might try a college and find out it isn't for them and transfer. Nothing wrong with that either. It may not be perfect, but it will be what you make of it. Grab it. This is your future, nobody else's future. You have some really exciting times coming. Embrace life and all its challenges. Try something new. Travel. Expand your horizons. Remember, you are ready. Bordentown Regional High School has prepared you. You have prepared you. Parents, friends, and family members, thank you all for all you've done, and thank you for allowing us to guide these young men and women. It has been our privilege and our pleasure. Members of the Bordentown Regional High School class of 2021, on behalf of our faculty and administration, we congratulate you tonight and wish you the very best always. Remember what you have accomplished, what you have right now, and what lies ahead of you. Thank you.
A feature of graduation is the transfer of office from outgoing president of the senior class to the incoming president of the senior class. This symbolizes the transfer of leadership from one class to another. It is my pleasure to introduce the president of the class of 2021, Ms. Emily Wheeler. Emily will transfer responsibility to Ms. Feha Faruqi, president of the class of 2022.
I'm a little tall for this. Good evening, everyone. My parents have made a lot of very good decisions in their life. Not to brag, but the best one is standing right in front of you. Victoria, you weren't such a bad one either. But the best one was seeing an ad in a paper and moving all the at the time, the three of us, my mom, my dad, and I, to this small little town called Bordentown. Bordentown. Where is that? By now, you all know the look, and you all rehearse the, 15 minutes south of Trenton. When I was younger, I hated explaining where Bordentown was. I wish we had a cool hangout spot, like Luke's and Gilmore Girls, or Central Perk, like in Friends. I didn't like how small my class were, or that I couldn't ride my bike everywhere. I was also so surprised that so many people were here their whole lives, or went away and came back. There's a whole world to see. What's so great about a little farm town, besides the fact that there's two Wawas? It wasn't until I had decided to move away for college that I started noticing how special Bordentown really is. I look at my fellow graduates, and I know everyone's name. I look into the crowd, and I see old room moms and old soccer coaches. I drive around and see how easy it is to get places. I walk down the hallways, and the teachers know my name. I was able to go 10 minutes down the street for basketball practice. During the summer, I had many options of which summer camps I could attend. I'm excited to move to California, but I'm even more excited to come back and fall in love with this town all over again. With this in mind, Feha, I hope you spend the next year of your life appreciating everything Bordentown has to offer. Graduating isn't an excuse to speed through the next year, but a reason to slow down. When school goes back to normal, eat lunch with your third grade best friend. Talk to your teacher about why they decided to teach here. Trust me, you will be surprised. Try a French toast bagel, one of my favorite from Bordentown Bagels, and then a gelati at the Creamery. Walk around Bordentown City with some friends, watch a soccer game at Friendship Field, dance the night away at prom with your best friends. Wake up each and every day excited that you have the ability to learn new things with old friends. And for goodness sakes, as much as it pains me to say, enjoy being young, because you will have enough time to get a job, enough time to get married, and enough time to see the world. But high school ends. Today's that day for me. The cap and gown, don't give that away. Today, we say goodbye to everything that was familiar, everything that was comfortable. We're moving on, but just because we're leaving, and that hurts, there are some people and places who are so much a part of us that will be with us no matter what. Now to my fellow graduates, as you go off into the world, I hope you see every city, every country, and every ocean. But I hope you keep in mind that no matter how far you go, how long time has passed, or how difficult your life might be, you will always have a home here in Bordentown, zip code 08505. Thank you. I'm beyond honored to introduce one of my great friends and the new senior class president, Beha Faruqi.
Thanks, Emily. I'm not as tall as you, so. Good evening. My name is Beha Faruqi, and I'm the class of 2022 president. I would first like to congratulate the class of 2021 on their graduation from Bordentown Regional High School. I want to acknowledge all the hard work, dedication, and motivation that all of you showed throughout this difficult learning experience. I have watched this class grow for the past 3 years and firsthandedly have seen you all become the inspiring and driven individuals you are today. Now, as the incoming senior class, I believe we are ready to fill in your shoes as the role models of our school. I'm honored to be accepting the passed down gavel from the class of 2021's president, Emily Wheeler. Following in Emily's footsteps will be an extremely difficult task. You've led this class through their ups and downs and stayed committed to helping them experience the best 4 years possible. If I even do half as good a job as you did, I believe that this upcoming school year will be a success. I'm ready to face challenges head on and am prepared for the responsibilities that come with this role. I look forward to dedicating my time to my class to make sure their senior year is unforgettable and as memorable as it can be. Speaking for myself, alongside the class of 2022, we congratulate you and wish you the best of luck on your journeys after graduation. Thank you.
It is now time, the part we have been waiting for, the presentation of diplomas. I will be assisted by Dr. Forsthoffer, Ms. Francisco Cabus, Ms. Morley, Mrs. Huff, Ms. Rabenda, Ms. Ashton, Ms. Loosner, and over there we will have Mrs. Smith and Ms. Tartaglia. Dr. Forsthoffer, it is my honor to certify that the members of the class of 2021 have met all of the requirements for the diploma set forth by the state of New Jersey and the Bordentown Regional Board of Education. So it is with great pleasure I present to you the class of 2021. Ms. Rabenda.
I will now introduce the individual graduates. Sonia Abbasi. Mario Agnoli. Aiden Amankwa. Jillian Elizabeth Baker. Saimir Bennett. T. Tierra Marie Biddle. Jaden Jonathan Harvey Blanding. Zane Sohaib Bukhari. Christopher Jaden Braxton Malone. Marissa Louise Brielle. Kevin John Britt. Mia Rose Brown. Brandon Buonanno. Kaylin Buonanno. Elena Calderon. Jack Satimo Carey. Isabel Marie Cartagena. Shannon Caroline Chamberlain. Leanne Chen. Jeremy Nathan Clemens. Justin David Clemens. Shamir Coleman Smith. Morgan Collins. Reagan Teresa Calora. Sierra Nicole Conover. Patrick Joseph Conroy. Jason Anthony Conti. Haley Lynn Cope. Joxander Correa Serrano. Alexis Costa. Andre James Costin. Matthew Ryan Kucha. Kelly Cuenca. Gianna Nicole DeBronzo. Deidre Dadzi. Raphael A. Damoa. Callie Jenna Dar. Jocelyn Vanessa Delgado. Nicholas Stephen Demkowitz. Alicia Nichelle Diaz. Christy Diaz. Isabella Grace Donnell. Kayla Nicole Downing. Eleanor Scout Dunleavy. Jemmy Edrelin. Nicholas T. Eifert. Kyle Hyojun Un. Hydea Lorray Ford Davis. Justin Michael Franz. Tyler Xavier Gentry. George Andreas Gergachulis. Sean Garricky. Nicholas Anthony Gambaluca. Arman Singh Gill. Gabriella Jada Golanecki. Lennon Gonzalez. Connor Graham. Cricket Elizabeth Graham. Arthur Joseph Gramlich. Matthew Christopher Greenmeyer. Mitchell Henry Greenmeyer.
Mehmet John Harset. Aiden David Hart. Ella Marie Hollenbeek. Benjamin Avery Heller. Phoebe Potts Henry. Chloe Alexa Hess. Matthew Ross Hoffman. Dobin Huang. Barbara Francesca Imberja. Samantha Jean Inman. Sebastian Livno Jokum. Destiny Marie Johnson. Carly Elizabeth Jones and Kyle Edward Jones. Mia Lynn Jones. Amanda Blair Jordy. Dakota Rose Judding. Joseph Robert Cagle. Nikki Eleftheria Carnavas. Morgan Rain Cato. Aiden Isaac Kennedy. Gavin Joseph Knight. Bryn Meadow Krauser. Justin Alexander Kirko. Ian Hongwei Landers. Carson Latham. Nicholas Mitro Lazoric. Brianna Lucia Lemo. Calvin Joseph Leung. Ayana Anaje Lewis. Matthew Justin Logadice. Gabriella Looney. Marissa Victoria Lorang. Riley Noel Lawrence. Sabrina Lubrano. Christian James McFarlane. Rishi Raj Makanpali. Kyle McGowan. Brendan John Malkin. Shreya Monick. Bilkisu Mansure. Ashley Marie Marchetti. Bibi Jasmine Martinez. Lucas Joseph Mayo. Sophie Elena McAteer. Ethan Mark McGlone. Elena Rose Meyer. Dante Joseph Metz. Andrew Gerard Meyer. Suchir Rao Mididadi. Adriana Montanez. Joanna Paige Moore. Miles Anthony Roger Morris. Antoine Darius Mosley. Andrew Connor Muller. Logan Everett Murray. Charlotte Brooke Nyerator. Jessica Lynn Norcross.
Brianna O'Neill. Xavier Ortiz. Hunter Stephen Parrish. Siona Sarin Patel. Autumn Patterson. Jillian Teresa Perez. Francisco Javier Planes Borgstrom. Jack Loyal Platt. Daniel John Poinsett. Dhruv Prasanna. Mohammed Rahman. Joseph William Ream. Brianna Marie Reed. Katie M. Reichert. Charlie Lewis Reevy. Shane Ritter. Haley Marie Robinson. Isaiah Rodriguez. Nicholas Anthony Romano. Stephen Christopher Roundtree. Haley Elizabeth Russell. Taylor Lynn Russell. Faith Annalise Russo. Aaliyah Nicole Zagardia. Victoria Saida. Logan James Saarinen. Lucas Alexander Shook. Ian Scott. Ishmael Ali Sadie. Jagmeet Singh. Taryn Preet Singh. Rebecca Slate. Peter William Slayback. Raina Michelle Smith. Emery Ashton Smolin. Caitlin Marie Sprague. Anthony Stanton. Keenan Riley Tornquist. Brandon David Valeri. Tomas Valois. Matthew Luke Wade. Messiah Harlem Walker. Allison Julia Wall. Madeline Paige Walters. Emily Greer Wheeler. Brian M. White. Maximilian James White. Donovan White. Trenise Jaquel Williams. Jessica Jillian Wilson. Kenna Marie Wojcik. Connor Michael Wood.
Go ahead, give them a big, nice round of applause. We're going to hold on for a minute. We've got one more thing we need to do. It's not an activity, but it is a task. It's a thing we have to take care of before we can head on out of here tonight. Class of 2021, you were amazing tonight. But there was no doubt in my mind that you would be. Families, after this final task for our class of 2021 graduates, they will be joining you down here on the turf for pictures and celebration. Therefore, you can just hold tight down here where you are. Here we go. Will the graduates please rise? And now that you have graduated, please transfer your tassel from the right side of your cap to the left. Congratulations. You are now officially Bordentown Regional High School alumni.